Welcome everyone. In this session, we are going to see multiplexers and demultiplexers. So what is a multiplexer? A multiplexer is a device that will allow information from several resources or sources to be routed onto a single line. For example, you can take your FM channel. So when you use your FM channel, you'll be hearing songs from different sources. But the output is a single source. If you select your channel, whatever is available in the channel will be audible to you. So multiplexer is a similar device where it is going to select the data. It will also act as a data selectors. In a multiplexer, you'll be having several data input lines, but there'll be only one single output line. With respect to your data line, you'll also be having your select lines. Now, if there are n data input lines, then you'll be having, okay, let us take that. If you are having n select lines, you'll be having 2 to the power of m data lines. So if there are n select lines, you'll be having 2 to the power of m data lines. This is also one case. Now, when we are seeing in this next, as we see it next, I'll just discuss about that. Now we'll try to implement a multiplexer and see how it is working. Generally, a multiplexer will be having 2 to the power of m input lines and n select lines. So if your select line is, if you have n select lines, then the number of input lines will be 2 to the power of n. You can assume that it is 2 to the power of n, and the output line, there will be only one output line in a multiplexer. Say suppose if n is equal to 1, if your select line is equal to 1, then what is the number of input lines I'll be having? I'll be having 2 input lines, and always the output line will be a single output line. This is a 2:1 MUX. Now here you can see this is a 2:1 MUX. Let me take the inputs. So this is first input and this is the second input. And I have one select line. Let us make this as the select line. And I'll be having only one output, I told. So I'll be having only one output. Now, so this output, let me label the output to be Y. So I've labeled the output to be Y. And this input, let me label this input to be I naught, I zero, I naught, anything you can take. And let me label this input to be I one. And this is a select line. So let me label the select line to be S or select. You can write anything. Now what happens? This input will be connected here. So it is over here, and this is the select line. Now, what happens? I've kept both the inputs as 1 and 1. If select line is 0, whatever is there in I naught will be available in Y. So if I naught is 0, even though I1 is 1, we are not getting any output. If I naught is 0, output will be 0. If I naught is 1, output is 1. If select line is 1, whatever is available in I1 will be available at the output. Y will be equal to I1. So you can see I1 is 1, so output is 1, even though I naught is 0. Now if I make I naught as 0, even though this is 1, I'm not getting the output. Because whatever is there in I naught, I1 will be available at Y if select is equal to 1. We have the functional diagram of a multiplexer over here. We will be having n data input lines, only one output line and select line. 2 to the power of n data input means we will be having n select lines. Out of these data inputs, whatever is your select value, based on that you'll get the output. Now 2:1 MUX. So I had select line 0, 1, and output is Z or Y. So we can take anything as the output. I took it as Y. So you can write it as Z or Y. Okay. So if select line is 0, I0 will be available at the output. If select line is 1, I1 will be available at the output. So what will be your Y equal to? If you write the expression Y is equal to, or Z or Y, both. Z or Y is equal, not Y bar Z. It is Y is equal to, Z is equal to. What is S over here? S is 0. So it will be S bar into I0 plus S into I1. According to our K-map, S bar into I0 plus S into I1 will be the expression. So S bar, so we have S over here. I've got a S bar since I've given it to a, here not gate. This is a not gate. You can also complement and give it over here. But let us replace this by a not gate. So this is a not gate. I0 into S bar plus S is going as it is into I1. Or both, you'll get the logic diagram. You can draw the regular logic diagram. So this is a 2:1 mux. Now the next one is 4:1 mux. Now in a 4:1 mux, 4:1 mux means 4:1. That means that clearly indicates n is equal to 2, which means our select line, we will be having two select lines and the number of input lines will be 4, 4:1. The number of input lines is 4, so the select lines will be 2. So 4 select lines, 2 select lines. Let us take the select lines as S0 and S1. Now if you have 2 select lines, what is the number of combinations you will be getting? Input combinations will be 4 combinations. So in a 2 input select line, will be, if you have 2 select lines, you will be getting 4 combinations. This is the truth table for mux. Okay, 4 combinations, S0 and S1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. 4 inputs. So when it is 0, 0, I0 will be selected, output will be equal to I0. When your select line is 0-1 combination, output will be equal to I1. When your select line is 1-0 combination, output will be equal to I2. When your select line is 1-1, output will be equal to I3. So what will be the expression now? Our expression Z will be equal to S0 bar S1 bar into I0. I0 plus S0 bar into S1 into I1 plus S0 into S1 bar into I2. OR gate, it is an OR gate. Plus the last one is S0 into S1 AND gate it is. So S0 AND with S1 AND it with I3. So this is the expression for the 4:1 mux. Let us code the mux. 4:1 mux. File, new project. Mux. Next. Next. Finish. Right click. New source. Very long module. So mux only I will take. Module name is mux. Now what are the inputs in the mux? We have 4:1 mux, I0, I1, I2, I3. So let me name the input as I, 3 down to 0. So this is 3 down to 0. There was one more input, select. So we have, that is 1 down to 0. 4 inputs, 2 select lines, and output is Y, 1 output. So I got that. I have 1 output, 1 input I, and 1 select line S. Verilog is case sensitive, so we should be very careful with the capitals and small letters, what we are going to, what we are using. So this is a semicolon, this is a semicolon, and here I have a semicolon. Now, let us code it using behavioral model. All output should be declared in registers. Always add. Now here you can write only select line for mux. The output of the mux depends on the select line. But for easier safe, I'll write both select as well as input. Begin. If S is equal to 2 tick B 0 0, Y is equal to I of 0. Else if S is equal to, so it is an assignment operator, so it is equal to, S is equal to 2 tick B 0 1. Y is equal to I of 1, else if S equal to 2 tick B 1 0, Y is equal to I of 2, else Y is equal to 0, 1, 2, okay, else if, I'll take you in the last condition, S is equal to, you can ignore the last condition and write it as else only, that will also work. Else if, S is equal to 2 tick B, 1, 1, Y is equal to I of 3, the last condition I'll take, else Y is equal to 1 tick BZ, I'll give 1 tick BZ or X so that I'll know the difference in the waveform. And the next one I have is end. I think I should give a semicolon over here. Save. I'll just check the syntax. Syntax is correct. So now let me see, we'll check the RTL schematic. See, you're using an FPGA, off-the-shelf FPGAs. Your RTL schematic will not match with the logic diagram what you have drawn. Only your black box diagram, the number of inputs and outputs will match. So 4-bit I, 2-bit select line. Now we have a MUX. MUX is also known as a data selector. So FPGA already has a data selector as a building block. That is why I've got the same diagram equivalent to what we have seen in the circuit verse. So 4-bit input, 2-bit select line, and I'll get the schematic. Now let us write the test bench. New source, Verilog test fixture. So all this I've got. What is the size of I? I is 4 tick B. I is 4-bit in size. 4 tick B 0 0 0 0. And here I'll take S is equal to 2 tick B 0 0. This four, this can be anything. You can give any combination from 0000 to 1111. So the next I will just give different values. Let me make this as 2. So I'll make some 1 and 1. And this I'll make it as 0, 1. The next combination, let me make this as 1 and 1. And here I'll make it as 1, 0. I can take any combination. I'll take everything as 1, 1. And this I'll make it as 1, 1. You can give your own combinations out of the 16 test cases we have. initial. So to, after 12 seconds it will stop. So I'll give hash 15 dollar stop. You should also print it in console window. I'm not giving the print statement. Check syntax. And I am simulating. When my select line is 000, what will be selected? I naught will be selected. So which is I naught? I naught is 0. I told when we keep the pointer over here, the values will be shown over here. So when it is 00, clear you can see that I naught is 0. Since I naught is 0 here, 00, I naught is 0, so y will be equal to 0. Let me move the pointer. Now at this position, select line is 01. When it is 01, what happens? Whatever is there in I1 will be available at y. Now what is there in I1? You can see that 1. I1 is 1. So y will be equal to 1. Like that, when we take the last combination, 11, I3, whatever is there in I3 will be available. I3 is 1, so value will be 1. If I3 was 0, I would have got the value as 0. Now the next one, what we are going to see is implementing Boolean functions using multiplexes. Now to implement a Boolean function, let us take one example. F of a comma b comma c, a comma b comma c, that it is a Boolean function which I'm taking, three variable Boolean function. F of a, b, c will be equal to summation m of, so summation m of 1, 3, 5 and 6. 1, 3, 5 and 6. Now this is a three variable Boolean expression what I've taken. In a three variable Boolean expression, what is the number of combinations we get? Totally we get 8 combinations, 8 input combinations. We will totally get 8 input combinations in a three variable Boolean function. So the number of inputs will be, to implement this function, will be equal to 8 inputs, 2 to the power of 3. 2 to the power of 3 is equal to 8, which is equal to our inputs. What about our select lines? Select line is equal to the number of input variables. So number of input variables is 3. Our select line will be equal to 3. Now let us see how to implement this using a multiplexer. Now to design this circuit, 8 input combinations means clearly it is told that I require a 8:1 MUX. This is a basic MUX. You can also implement using lower order MUX, 4:1 MUX, 1 MUX also. But now we'll see a 8:1 MUX. So now to implement this using 8:1 MUX, this is a multiplexer what I've taken. How many inputs I have? 8 inputs. So 0, 1, 2 up to 7. This is 0 to 7. So let me label the inputs as, this will be the minterm 0. So now I have minterm 0, M0. The next one is M1. The next one is M2. The next one is M3, M4, M5, M6 and M7. Okay, so I'll just label the last one. The last one is nothing but M7. I will also label some more. Just let me label it as M3. You have to label. You'll be having M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, and M7. Now this is how an 8:1 mux looks like. So you can see an 8:1 mux will be having 8 input combinations. So M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6 and M7. 3 variables are there, so they'll act as 3 input combinations. 3 select lines A, B and C, and 1 output is there, Y, which is our output. Or we heard it is our function F of A, B and C. So we can write this Y is equal to F of A, B, C. Now when you're trying to implement this function using an 8:1 mux, what happens? Minterm, this expression is related to minterm. Since it is minterm, 1, 3, 5, 6 is there in the question. Connect 1, 3, 5, 6 to VDD or logic 1. All of the minterms will be connected to 0. So what are the values which I have over here? So what should be connected to 0 and what should be connected to 1? Now whatever is there in the question, according to us, what is there in the question? 1. So 1 should be connected to logic 1. 3 should be connected to logic 1 again. So I have 3. Three should be connected to logic one. Three should be connected to logic one. Five should be connected to logic one. And what is the next one? Six should be connected to logic 1. Next, what about the next one? Whatever is remaining, M0, all this should be connected to logic 0. M0 will be connected to logic 0. M2 is connected to logic 0. M4 will be connected to logic 0. And M7 will also be connected to logic 0. This is how you are going to implement a Boolean expression using a multiplexer. 8:1 mux. Now, if you want to implement the same Boolean expression using 4:1 mux, how will you implement it using a 4:1 mux? This is using 8:1 mux. Now, to implement the same Boolean function using a lower order mux, not 8:1 mux, 4:1 mux, we should have something known as implementation table. Now in a 4:1 mux, how many functions we have? We'll be having only 4 inputs and 1 select line. So let me take the input as D0. Let me take it as D0, D1, D2 and D3 because there will be only 4 inputs. D1, 2, 3 and 4. I've given the name variable name as D0, D1, D2, D3. Now, which variable you're going to, you can keep one of the variables constant. Which variable are you going to keep it constant and which variable you're going to use it? So now what I will do, I will keep in this function B and C, I will retain it. A, I will keep it as constant. I will keep A as constant. B and C, I'm keeping it as constant. A, I will be using. So how do I use that? Now, D0, D1, D2, D3. Let us use A. A can take how many values? 0 and 1. So A can take the value 0, which means it is A bar. A can take the value 1, which means it is a. The literal A can have, literal A can take the values 0 and 1. So A can be 0, A can be 1. Now you have the min term over here, 1. What does this min term 1 represents? Min term 1 represents our combination is 0, 0, 1. Now which is a variable? This is equal to variable A, B, C, which means A is 0, B is 0, C is 1. You can write the truth table also and you can fill it from the truth table. A is 0, B is 0 and C is 1. So now, what does that mean? This means here I have a 0. The first four combinations of the truth table, the next four combination. You can also think it like this. Then, what about this? Okay. This, let me fill it as for now, 1, 2, 3. This is the first mark. So let me do it like this. 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now, what are the min terms we have? 1, 3, 5 and 6. So let us select the min terms. 1, 3, 5 and 6. 5 and 6. These are the min terms. So I have selected these min terms. Now you have to write the next line. So in the next column of the truth table, you're going to fill it. If none of the min terms is selected, the value will be 0. So this is 0. If both the columns are selected, it is 1. If either of the column is selected, so here you can see 6 is selected, which is nothing but A. So this will be equal to A. The last one is nothing but A bar. So this is how we are writing. Now this is the table. This is actually a table what we have. This is known as the implementation table. If both the values are not selected according to the min terms, it is 0. If both are selected, it is 1. If any one is selected, then you have to take the equivalent value. So 6, it is equal to A, and this is equal to A bar. So what are the four values we got? We got 0, 1, A and A bar. Now let us see how to implement this using a MUX. 4 is to 1 MUX. We are using the reduced version of the MUX. Now this we are going to implement using a 4 is to 1 MUX. 4 is to 1 MUX, 4 input combinations I have. So this is D0, D1, D2 and D3. How many select lines we have? 2 select lines we will be having. So this select line and one more select line we will be having. This is another select line which we are having. So this is another select line. And one output I'll be having. One output. This is a 4 is to 1 MUX. Now how are we going to assign values? Now if you can see, what is D0 equal to? D0 is equal to 0. D1 is equal to 1. D2 is equal to A. D3 is equal to A bar. So here, this is D0 is equal to 0. So the second one, 0 means it should be connected to a logic 0. So D1 is equal to 1. What is the third one we have? D2 is equal to A bar. So D2 is equal to A, not A bar. D2 is equal to A. And what is D3? D3 is equal to, what is the value? A bar. So this you can give us the connections, or directly I can write it as A bar the connection to this mux is, to this I'll be giving a logic 1, to this I'll be giving a logic 0. And what about these two over here? One of the select line will be B, the other select line will be C. This is nothing but our output F. So this is how we are going to implement the given Boolean function. The next example is implement the function F of C, B, A. F of C, B, A using A as constant. See, yesterday in the previous session, what we did, we took A as constant and this function was A, B, C. Now we have taken the LSB to be constant and we are going to implement this function. So now when we implement that function, what happens? Let us write the truth table 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. 100 11 110 111, and this function is in the format. The first one is C, the second one represents B, and the third one represents A. Now we have taken A as the constant, and the output is here. It is M1. This is the function we have taken it as F. In F, M1 is 1. M3 is 1, M5 is 1, and we have M6 is 1. So implement this using A as constant, and it is implement using 4:1 mux. Implement the following Boolean function using 4:1 mux. Now how do we do this? Now let us take the truth table. Let us do the implementation table first. Now when you do the implementation table, what do you have? You will be having D0, D1, D2 and D3 in the implementation. What is to be taken constant? We have to take A as constant and A bar as constant. So first you can either write it as A bar or A, no problem. A bar and A. Now, summation of 1, 3, 5 and 6. So which is your 1? This is your 1. Now in this 1, what is the value of A? Now when we take this 1, what is the value of A? A bar? Is it A bar or A? It is A. So here it will be our minterm 1. Let us write the implementation table. Now when you're drawing the implementation table, we have to consider what is A0 and what comes under A bar and what comes up for A. Now if you can see the table, A is 0 over here. 0 represents A bar. So min term 0 will be represented over here. Now A is 1 over here, A is 1, so min term 1 comes over here. A is 2, this is min term 2, but the value is 0, so min term 2. Now this is min term 3, but the value of A is 1, so it comes over here. 4, 5, 6 and 7 in the similar way you have to do it. So now what you have to do, the remaining steps are the similar to the previous problem. What we have to do next, we have to group it. So when you group it, if you group it, you can see what are the things that are getting grouped. M1, M3, M5, M6. So I have M1 over here, M3 over here, M5 over here and M6 over here. Now, what will be our D0 equal to? D0 will be equal to, what is the D0 equal to? D0 is equal to A. What is D1 equal to? D1 is equal to A. What is D2 equal to? D2 is equal to A. And what is D3 equal to? D3 will be equal to A bar. This is how we are grouping. एंड इफ यू आर ग्रुपिंग द सेम, दिस इज द सेम थिंग इफ द क्वेश्चन इज गिवन गिवन एज इम्प्लीमेंट द फंक्शन f of c comma b comma a keeping c as constant. If c is constant, what happens? Now if c is constant, how will the implementation table look? So let me take the implementation table for c is equal to constant. I'm just mentioning it as c as constant. How will our implementation table for c equals constant look like? I will be having d naught, d1, d2, d3. And what do I have over here? I'll be having c as constant, that is c bar, and in the next column I write c. Now what happens? You can see 0, 1, 2, 3. See here, if you can see in the truth table, 0, m0 has c0, m1 has c0, m2 has c0, m3 has c0. So what happens? We will write m0 over here, m1 over here, m2 over here, and m3 over here, because everything is 0. Next, you can do this even for b is equal to, you can implement this implementation table even considering b as constant. So this will be 4, 5, 6, and 7. This is the same implementation which we have solved in the previous problem. Now, how will this look like? What will be the solution if you take C as constant? So this is the implementation table. Since it's a table, it should be in a tabular format. Now, how do we solve it? If you solve it, according to the question, it is M1, M3, where's M3? M3, M5, M5 and M6. So this is the implementation. This is the implementation table. Now what happens if you solve according to this? D0 will be equal to, none of that is selected. None of the minterms are selected. If none of the minterms are selected, the value will be 0. Next, D1, both the minterms are selected. If both the minterms are selected, then the value will be equal to 1. Then what will be D2 equal to? D2 will be equal to what is selected? The C is selected. D2 will be equal to C. D2 is equal to C. And what is D3 equal to? D3 will be equal to C bar. Now this is how it is selected. And we can draw the 4 is to 1 marks. This goes to the first input, second, third input. And let us see what happens if B is to be kept constant. So now let us assume that B is to be kept constant, given B is equal to constant. Now if B is constant, how do we write the implementation table? So B is constant. Here I'll be having B bar, and the next column will be B. And what goes over here? So D0, D1, D2 and D3. Now, first two you can see 0 and 0. So here I'll be having minterm 0, minterm 0. What about the next one? Next two according to the truth table is 1 and 1, which means B is equal to, this is minterm 1. So the next, in the next column, you'll be having 2 and 3. And go to D2. D2 will be again, 2 and 3 is done. 4 and 5 is this one. And the next, and in the next column, you'll be having 4 and 5, 6 and 7. This is the implementation table when we have B is constant, when we are assuming B is to be constant. Now what happens to the function? Boolean expression, I mean, what is D0 equal to? According to our minterms, let us find what is D0, D1, D2, D3 equal to. 1, 3, 5, 6 is the question. So 1, 3, 5, and 6. So now according to this, we will get D naught is equal to 0 because none is selected. D1 is equal to 1. What is D2? D2 is equal to B. And what is D3? D3 is equal to B bar. So this is how you're going to implement using various functions. And all this you have to draw, a mux and fill it up. So let us draw a 4:1 mux keeping C as constant. So I'll keep C as constant and I'll show a 4:1 mux. Okay, keeping A as constant, I'll do the mux. Let us keep A as constant and solve the mux. So I have a 4:1 mux, 4 inputs, D0, D1, D2, and the next one is D3. This is a 4:1 mux. Now what is D0 is equal to? D0 will be equal to A. What is D1? This can be in any order. It need not be in the same order. It can be in any order. So anyhow, here we have done it in this format. We'll do it in this format. D0 is equal to A. What is D1 equal to? D1 is also equal to A. D1 is equal to A. What is D2 equal to? D2 is equal to again A. You can connect everything since it is same A. All the three can be connected. And what is D3 equal to? D3 will be equal to A bar. Then it is a 4:1 mux. So we'll be having two select lines. We've already used A over here. So the next select line will be CB. We will write it in the format CB. So this is C, select line C, and I'll also be having one more select line over here. So this select line will be B. Two select lines are required. So this is a 4:1 mux using, I can write this as implementation of 4:1 mux for the given function. So 4:2 mux for the given function. So this is a 4:2 mux and we have solved it. So this is regarding implementation of a three variable x function, Boolean expression using 8:1 mux and using 4:1 mux. The next example Boolean function what we will take is, it is a four variable function f of a, b, c and d. Implement the function f of a, b, c, d. And the function is min term of 0, 0, 1, 2, 4, 6, 9, 12, and 14. The function is 0, 1, 2, 4, 6, 9, 12, and 14. Now this function, four variable function. If it is a four variable function, the first thing is we can implement it using a 16:1 mux, which is a direct implementation. The second thing is you can implement it using 8:1 mux, similar to the previous problem what we have done. But the implementation table will have D0 to D7. The third one, a reduced version of this, we can also implement using 4:1 mux. So this way you can do the implementation for all the three categories. Now let us take another example. Boolean expression m of 0, 1, 2, 4, 6, 9, 12 and 14. And let us implement this Boolean expression using, since it's a 4 variable, we'll implement using 16 is to 1 marks. We can implement using 16 to 1 marks. Then we can also implement using 8 to 1 marks, and we can also implement using 4 to 1 marks based on the question. So we'll implement using 8 or 16 is to 1 marks first. The 4 variable Boolean expression, I'll be having a 4 variable truth table A, B, C, D, and the output is a function of A, B, C, D. So this is a truth table what we will be getting, A, B, C, D, and the output is a function of A, B, C, and D. Output is a function of F is a function of A, B, and C. So M0 means M0 is 1. M1 means M1 is 1. M2 is 1. M3 is not there, so it is 0. M4 is there, so it is 1. M5 is not there, 0. M6 is available in the question, so it is 1. Then I have M7 is not there. M8 is not there. M9 is a 1. M10 is not there. M11 is not there. 12 is there. 13 is not there. 14 is there. And 15 is a 0. So this is the Boolean truth table what we have got. Now we are going to implement using 16 is to 1 mux. So I have a mux over here. How many control signals we need? We need 4 control signals. So it is a 4 control signal, and this is our 16 is to 1 mux. Now this is a control signal over here. What are the control signals I have? A, B, C and D. So control signal A, B, C, and D. It is a 4-bit control signal. So I'll be having a 4-bit control signal. The first variable represents A. The second variable represents B. So I'll just write it as A, B, C, and D. So the first number will represent A. The second one represents B. The third one represents D and C. And the fourth one represents D. So we'll have a output. I'll just keep an LED over here. And now you have to set the inputs. So A, this is M0, this is M1. It goes on. You can set it M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5. Everything you can give. So I'll give some few inputs. So this goes to M0. This goes to M1 because it's there in the question. M0, M1, and I have an M2. I have to give input to all the combinations. M2, M3 also have to give an input. As of now, I'm not giving. So let me give this to M4. M4, I have M6, so this is related to M6. Then I have M9, so I'm giving this to M9, M12 and M14, so I'll keep two more, M12 and, so this I'm giving to M12. Or else, okay, this I'll give it to M12. I'll show you another alternate way also. This I'm giving it to M12. And this is given to M14. The last one is given to M14. Right. Now, what should be the value of all these things? All this should be equal to 1. And remaining whatever is not there in the combination, whatever I have not connected, which is equal to minterm 0. Whatever is not connected, that is this minterm 0, So I have a minterm 3 which is not connected 0. All the minterms related to zeros will be connected to a logic 0. So all you can select and we can connect it to logic 0. I'll just keep it over here, logic 0. What should be connected to logic 0? I have 3 that should be connected to logic 0. I have 5 that should be connected to logic 0. 7 to be connected to logic 0. 8 will get shorted since there's a wire that is going over there. Please space. So all this should be connected to logic 0. And a 15 over here which is connected. So everything should be connected to logic 0. And I have a F over here. It should get connected to logic 0. Okay. So this is a logic 0. Now, okay, all this will be connected over here. Make sure that there are no shorts over here. Okay. If it is shorted, you will not get the output. And why did I tell you the single one? Instead of using multiple ones, I can keep only a single one and connect M0, M1, M2, M4, M6, M9, M12, M14. Since everything will have the logic equivalent of one, I can use a single one. And here I can use a single zero. So you can connect it in the same way. Now this is with respect to 8 is to 1 MUX. Now this can be the complete 16:1 implementation for the given minterms, Boolean expression. Collect whatever is there to 1 and all others to 0. Now if you have to implement it using 4:1 MUX, first we have to write the implementation table. So first let us write the implementation table to implement that using 8:1 MUX and 4:1 MUX. Now to draw the implementation table, we need an 8:1 MUX, that is D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6 and D7. And which variable will take it as constant? Let us take A as constant since it is easy for us. So this will be A bar. This will be A bar and the next we'll take it as A. So now what happens over here? Here I'll be having 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 16 combinations in the minterm, 6 and 7. Next it is 8, we'll be having 9, 10, 11, 11, 12, 13, 14, and a 15. So these are the minterms what I will get. Now let us group it. According to the question, we have to group it. So what is there in the question? I have 0, then I have 1, 2, 4, 6, 9, 12 and 14. So I've already grouped it. Now we have to apply the rules and come out with the inputs to the MUX. So this is a table. Let us complete it as table. So this is the implementation table. So now let us write the next values. So what will be our values? D0 will be equal to A bar. Clearly we can see over there. D1 will be equal to, if both are selected, then the value will be 1. again d2 will be equal to a bar, d3 will be equal to 0. If none is selected, then it will be equal to 0. Again, if both are selected, it is equal to 1. If nothing is selected, then it will be equal to 0. And here both are selected, it is equal to 1. And the last one will be a 0. Now this we have to implement it using a 8 is to 1 mux. First we'll do 8 is to 1, then go to 4 is to 1 mux. So let me take a mux. 8 is to 1 mux. I'll remove this table. So I have a mux, it is an 8 is to 1 mux. So 8 is to 1 mux means I'll be having 3 control signals. One output I'll be having. So this is the output which I have for the function. So let me name it as F. And now related to the control signals, 3-bit control signal. So it is a 3-bit control signal. 3-bit control signal will be leaving A, it is B, comma C and D. It is B, comma C, comma D because we have taken our A as constant. And what is the size of this? This should be 3-bit in size. So let me increase the bandwidth, 3-bit in size. The first variable represents B, second one represents C and the third one represents D. So this is respect to the control signal, done. Now what we have to do? This 0, 1, 2 represents D0, D1, D2. Now, what and all is connected? So, I'll just keep a 1 over here. I have a 0, I'll be having a 1. Now, what is connected to 0? D3, D5, D7. D3. D5. And D7 is connected to a 0. What is connected to 1? So D3, D5, D7 is over 1. D1, D4, D6. So I take D1, next what do I have? D4 is connected to 1 and D6 is also connected to the 1. Next, what I have, D0 is connected to A bar and D2 will be connected to A bar. So D0 and D2 is connected to A bar. I'll just represent A bar with using an arrow. So this represents A bar. So I'll give the label as A bar. And what is connected? This is connected to D0 is connected to A bar and also D2 is connected to A bar. So that's it. This is how you're going to implement the function using 8 is to 1 mux. Now let us implement the same function using 4 is to 1 mux. Now how will we implement a general 4 is to 1 mux? A 4 is to 1 mux will have 4 inputs and 1 output. But an 8 is to 1 mux implemented using 4 is to 1 mux requires 2 4 is to 1 mux. Now to implement this structure, we require 2 4 is to 1 mux. So I'll take 2 4 is to 1 mux with enable. Enable, I'll not be able to represent. Okay, enable. Okay, let me take this. So 4 is to 1 mux. Okay, now 4 is to 1 mux will have 2 select lines. So I will take 3 select lines, which means, okay, I'll take 2 select lines and this also I will take 2 select lines. So this is a 4 is to 1 mux and this is a 4 is to 1 mux. Now this represents D0, D1, D2, D3 and the control signal over here. So 2 control signals I'll take, the last 2 control signals or anyone you can take, B, C, D, whatever it is, you can take that. So this will take the control signal B and C. So let us take this as control signal C and D. So C comma D, and it is 2-bit in size, and this will have again the same control signal. As per implementation rules, it will be the same control signals for both. So C comma D over here, and at the same time it will be the same C and D even here also. C and D. Now in the output, two outputs I'll be getting. So I have to use an OR gate to get the outputs, because it is either of that. I may have an output which is either of the other two. So I'll put an OR gate over here. I can even use a 2:1 mux over there. Instead of an OR gate, I can use a 2:1 mux also. But I've used a 4:1 mux, so I'll just... Okay, if you use a 2:1 mux, I can give one variable over here. So I'll show both the combinations so that it is easy for you. Now this is like this. Now I had the variable A. I also have the variable C and D. This is anyhow D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6 and D7. So as per our rules, this will be equal to A bar. So in the same way previously how we did for 8:1 mux, this will be A bar. So I'll be having A bar over here. This will be A bar, and which one is D2 is also connected to A bar. This will also be A bar. D1 will be connected to 1, so I can have a logic 1 over here. D1 is connected to logic 1, I can also have a logic 0 over here. D1 is connected to logic 1, D3 will be connected to logic 0. And D4 is connected to logic 1, so 3, this will be 4. So this is D4 will be connected to logic 1. Okay. The next one is D5. D5 will be connected to logic 0. The next one is D6. D6 will be connected to logic 1. And the last one is D7 will be connected to logic 0. So this is how we are going to implement the given function using 4:1 mux. Now next, one more thing. What about B? You have to give B, right? So that B, you have to give it to the enable. In this figure, I'm not able to represent the enable. So let me take one enable signal. So I've taken this. This is nothing but the function B. Function B. B is given to a NOT gate. B is given to a NOT gate. And that is connected to the enable of the first mux. Okay, without the NOT gate, B without the NOT gate is connected to the enable of the second mux. So B with NOT gate is connected to the first mux. B without the NOT gate will be connected to the second mux. So this is B with the NOT gate to the first mux, and B, here I have B without the NOT gate. So this will be connected to the enable of the second mux. So this goes to the enable of the second mux. This is with respect to B. Now, suppose I don't want to use an enable. In the mux, I don't have an enable. Even without an enable, I can show this result. So let me see how that can be done without an enable. Now this is without an enable. I don't have an enable as of now. So what I'll do, instead of this OR gate over here, I'll remove this OR gate and place a 2 is to 1 MUX. Now I can place a 2 is to 1 MUX over here. How many inputs are there? This is the first one which goes to the first input, the second one over here. So clearly it is showing over here, when your enable is 0, the first MUX will be selected. When your enable is 1, the second MUX is selected. So what is the signal which goes to the enable? So as of now, we have not given B. So this should be B. This should be B. When B is 0, the first one will be selected. When B is 1, the second one will be, the second MUX will be selected as per the multiplexer rules. This way also it can be done. Now this is with respect to multiplexer implementation. Now next, suppose you have to design a MUX, like implement a 16 is to 1 MUX using 4 is to 1 MUX, 16 is to 1 MUX using a 4 is to 1 MUX. Now if you have to design a 16 is to 1 MUX using 4 is to 1 MUX, how many input combinations you have? You have 16 input combinations. See, the input over here is 16, but we are going to use 4. To achieve 16, how many 4 is to 1 MUXs we require? We require 4 4 is to 1 MUXs. So let us take a 4 4 is to 1 MUX. So this is 1 4 is to 1 MUX. 4 is to 1 MUX will have two control signals. So I have another 4 is to 1 MUX. Another one. And the last one. 4 4 is to 1 MUX is required to get a 16 is to 1 MUX. So this is also a 4 is to 1 MUX. And this is also 4 is to 1 MUX. Four control signals are required. Now, okay, 16 is to 1 MUX. 16 is to 1 MUX will have the combinations A, B, C and D. Now what will I do? I'll give two combinations over here and the two remaining two combinations to the other MUX. So first always we have to go with the lower order combination. So let us go with the lower order combinations. So this control signal over here, we have to have an input. What are the size of the input? It should be 2-bit in size. And let me label it as C and D. So C and D, even this is connected to C and D. Correct. The first four combinations of C and D, the next four combinations of C and D, the next four combinations of C and D, and the last four combinations of C and D. And this is input 0, input 1, you can connect it. I0, I1, I2, I3, which I'm not doing it, so I'm leaving it vacant. I0, I1, I2, I3, everything can be completed. Then I'll get an output from here. I'll get four outputs. Now, two more variables. If you have to implement a 16 is to 1, I need four select lines, A, B, C, D. C, D I have given. Still A and B is pending. So what I'll do, I'll use another MUX. Two variables are pending. That means I can use this as, I can make it as a 4 is to 1 MUX. The output of the first one will get connected to I0 over here in the this MUX. The output of the second one will get connected to I1. And this gets connected to the third one. And further, this gets connected to the fourth one. And I can keep the output. I can get the output at the end. So all outputs I can keep the output at the end. Now what about the control signal over here? I have to give 4 is to 1. So it is a 2-bit control signal. So I have to give a control signal over there. I'll give a control signal. So this is my control signal, which is with respect to this. So this is my control signal. Now what should be the size of this control signal? This control signal is 2-bit in size, because I have to implement two more variables. So it is 2-bit in size. And what is the value of the control signal? It will take the values A and B. Now clearly it is a 16 is to 1 marks using a 4 is to 1 marks. Like this you can go for any designing of marks until and unless they've mentioned use 2 is to 1, use 3 is to 1, implement 8 is to 1 for implement the 16 is to 1 using 8 is to 1, implement 4 is to 1 using 2 is to 1, implement 8 is to 1 using 4 is to 1, any marks you can build. Let us finish. Let us take another design. So now in the design, implement 8 is to 1 marks using 4 is to 1. Suppose if this is a question, we have already seen in the Boolean expression, but still I'll show one example. 4 is to 1 marks, I require 2 4 is to 1 marks for 8 is to 1 because 8 inputs. So this will be a 4 is to 1 marks. I also need one more 4 is to 1 marks. This will also be one 4 is to 1 marks. Now the control signal for a 4 is to 1 marks is a 2-bit control signal. So I'll be having a 2-bit control signal. Let us assume the function to be A, B, C, the function of A, B, and C. Now since the function is A, B, and C, two control signals I'll give it over here. So let us take two control signals over here. Control signal I've taken and it is 2-bit in size. So 2-bit in size. Let us implement BC and this is I0, I1, I2, I3. You can give the inputs which I'm not giving. So I'll just show one sample. One input can be connected and it is given over here. Now the last two, either I can use a 2 is to 1 marks and give an enable over here. Either I can use a 2 is to 1 marks and give the variable over there. So if I use a 2 is to 1 marks, 2 is to 1 marks. This is labeled as control signal B and C. This can have the control signal as A. So I can give an input with the control signal as A. So this is an input with the control signal A. And connect this to over here. So this will be a simple 8 is to 1 marks using 4 is to 1 marks without enable. If you use enable, you can give enable is equal to 0 over there and enable is equal to 1 for the next marks. Thank you.